Nissan presents GT Academy Road to Dubai.
Welcome to GT Academy, the road to Dubai. Over the next few weeks, we'll be looking at what happened when Nissan took a group of gamers out of their bedrooms and onto the race circuit. We follow Lucas Ordonez from Spain, the 2009 GT Academy winner who finished second in his class at this year's Le Mans and races in the Intercontinental Le Mans Challenge. And Frenchman Jordan Tresson, the 2010 GT Academy winner. He is now racing in the Blancpain Endurance Series in a Nissan 370Z. And we catch up too with Welshman Jann, the winner of the 2011 GT Academy, who has 3 months to gain an international license and join Lucas and Jordan for the chance of a lifetime driving in the Dubai 24-hour race. 3 gamers, 1 team, 1 race. Opened in 1952 on the edge of the town of Imola, the 5-kilometre Imola track is named after Enzo Ferrari and his son Dino. It's one of the Italian motorsport heartlands. For Lucas Ordonez, this is his first time back in a Signatec Nissan since his impressive run at Le Mans, and another chance to show the fans how far he's come.
We are in Imola for the 6 hours race for the Intercontinental Le Mans Cup. It's a difficult track, it's different than others. We just come back from Le Mans, which is totally the opposite track. Have long straights, good braking points. Le Mans was a big, big challenge for me. It's the biggest race in the world, and I was really under pressure. It was so tough because it's 24 hours, night driving, long stints. But here it's different, no? You've got a narrow track, very difficult to overtake, and the traffic here is much more difficult than Le Mans.
We are not fast enough comparing to the top two cars, but we improved the car with some changes in the setup. And the car will be better tomorrow.
It's great to see that people know about my story and they follow me in Twitter, Facebook and also in the tracks. And now I feel more like a driver than a PlayStation gamer.
You can see that he's got a special feeling for driving, and I'm sure PlayStation helped for that. We're trying to be like teachers for Lucas, and we're trying to give as much as advice as we can to understand more the car. It's not about his driving skills, it's just about experience, and it's been great to have him around.
First, there is a very good ambience. We are always joking, and it's a part of the team behavior. Now I can say just congratulations to him, because everything he done was perfect.
With the team qualifying in fourth, Sayaliari was first up in the driving seat to get the signature Nissan onto the podium.
We're fourth at the moment and we were second. And actually the car which was leading had a problem now, so we should be maybe leading. Now I think we're third on the podium, and keeping across for the end of the race.
Sayal finished a successful stint, climbing up a place to third as he handed over driving duties to teammate Frong. As Frong dealt with a busy track, he managed to pick up a place. The car was in second.
We are in position two. We see that two of our strongest competitors are in the box with problems. The leading car is really far away, so it's doing a great job.
and that's it. No, now we are trying to increase the gap with the third car, and let's see how it goes this this pit stop for Frank, and they'll go. I'll go in.
With the team well placed, Lucas had his chance to tackle the Imola track, getting back into the car for the first time since he raced at the 24 Hours of Le Mans.
I tried to keep a good rhythm. It was not easy with the traffic, but the team is happy with my stint, and then I decided to pitch and to let the soil finish the race.
Soil took over for the final stint, holding second in class to the line, keeping them ahead of their competition in the Intercontinental Le Mans Cup Series.
My teammates and the team Signa Technician did a great job.
And you? And you?
We started in B4 from the qualifying, and we finished second. So great job for the team. The team is improving every time we come for the races and testing, and I'm sure in Silverstone it will be better and we will do a really good job.
With another race over, but before heading home to Madrid, Lucas made a diversion to Silverstone to support the GT Academy winner for 2010 champion Jordan Tresson as he took part in a GT4 European Cup race. Having beaten over a million entrants at the second GT Academy, Jordan Tresson was back at Silverstone with the RGM team and teammate Alex Buncombe to take part in the GT4 European Cup.
Fantastic to be back here in the UK racing. Extremely nice weather here this weekend, and let's hope for a fantastic result.
Competing in the Blancpain Endurance season in 2011, Jordan and his teammates will battle it out in five races across Europe, including the prestigious Spa 24 Hours. Here at Silverstone, they're given the opportunity to brush up on their skills, taking part in the GT4 European Cup race to put the car they'd be using in the Blancpain series to the test. Having won the GT4 Endurance Cup in 2009, Lucas Ordonez was on hand to offer help and advice to his friend behind the wheel.
I had a little chat now with him, and you know, he needs to be focused, he needs to be really calm.
For this event, both Alex and Jordan would compete in individual races, with a third race on the final day in which they'd share the car.
His times are getting really, really close to mine now, so I'm going to have to start picking up my pace a bit.
Despite having started second on the grid, Alex managed to push himself up into first place and win the opening race. A great start to the season for the team.
Benchmark as possible was the first place, so I will obviously try to do the same.
With Alex having brought home the first silverware of the season, Jordan prepared for his opening race.
We'll start in third position, which is an incredible qualifying for him. Jordan is doing really well, he keeps third. He needs to keep calm and keep going without mistakes.
Under the watchful eye of team manager Bob Neville, Jordan came home a respectable third place, bagging the team's second silverware in as many hours.
He's done a really good job.
I won't complain, it's not the place I was aiming for, but third is better than nothing.
With the day over and two trophies already won, Jordan's focus turned to the final race, where he and Alex would share the driving.
Today there is only one race, it's a 15-minute race. I have to share the race with Alex.
Jordan started strongly, matching his rivals. It was all looking good for a podium finish until the car developed a problem.
The race was going well. I mean, I was third position with the force on my back. It would have been another podium, but we had a gearbox failure, so that's happened, you know, that's motorsport. So.
With the Spa 24 Hours just weeks away, the car was taken away to be worked on while Jordan and Alex continued with their training. J- during the season will follow all of our GT Academy winners as they head towards the Dubai 24-hour race, reputed as one of the toughest challenges in endurance motor racing for man and machine. Both Lucas and Jordan know how hard the task will be. They've been racing professionally since they won their academies, but for 2011 winner Jann Mardenborough and his teammate and housemate Brian Heitkotter, winner of the first GT Academy USA, they are at the start of a long journey. They've got a steep learning curve in front of them. Last time we saw Jann and Brian get awarded with two signatures as they raced in Pembrey. Each driver must gain 12 signatures in total to be granted the all-important license that will allow them to race in Dubai.
Today we're at Snetterton. It's raining, as usual in UK. We've got 8 signatures already, so this weekend we get another 2 if we finish. And then next week we're at Rockingham to get another 2. After that, we'd have our international seat.
Very exciting. It's amazing how quickly they're getting us into an international racing license.
Because of the results we got at Castle Coombe, the organisers bumped us up a class. So instead of racing against cars of a similar pace to where we think the 370 should be, we've been bumped up a class. It's a nice thing to happen because it shows that the guys are getting some respect, but it makes it a lot more difficult for them to get a strong result.
After a tricky start at Pembrey, Jann and Brian were at Snetterton in Norfolk to see how they would tackle the second longest track in the country. It's a 5-kilometre circuit with 13 corners and another chance to gain 2 vital signatures.
We're using radios for the first time this weekend. It's very useful sort of talking to Darren, a pit crew chief.
It can be a bit disconcerting to have a radio for the first time because you've got people talking to you and you've got to talk back, which when you're not used to it, it can kind of get you a bit confused.
For the first time, Jann would also be sharing the car with Brian Heitkotter, the North American GT Academy winner.
I've definitely become faster in the car since we started at Pembrey. Just kind of getting used to the car and learning how the car likes to be driven.
With rain over and the team qualifying at the back of the pack due to faster competition, they decided to focus on the driver changeover that would be a vital part of the Dubai 24-hour race.
With the situation here, because they're fueling up, the driver has to get out of the car and they shut the door and then do the fuel, and then the next driver has to get in.
With the driver change going according to plan, the team were back on track to finish the race and get those signatures.
Everyone remembered to take the steering wheel off and put it back on, which is always a favourite. We're only about 10 seconds over.
Worked pretty good, I think.
The race went well. I feel a lot more relaxed compared to the other events.
We finished 7th in the class, and we were right on the tails of the guys in front, so it was a good, strong drive.
I've sort of changed my attitudes, thinking of the long-term goals rather than thinking of the short-term. Keep a steady pace, don't do anything stupid. We've got another 2 signatures, so we've got 10 now, 2 more to go. In all, good weekend, really.
Next time, we'll catch up with second-year GT Academy winner Jordan Tresson as he takes on a 24-hour race of a different kind at the Nürburgring before heading to Belgium for the Spa 24 Hours. And we'll see how Jann trains for the racetrack as he takes on the iZone simulator in preparation for Rockingham. 3 gamers, 1 team, 1 race.
Virtual to real. Nissan presents.